Glenville, Minnesota is a great small community that's ag-related. My father, Wes, started in the fire service. When I became of age to get on the fire department, it was a right fit to help out the community. The training, the friends you meet, the items that you learn in life, that's the best thing about it.
My grandfather started our family farm. He moved out here, and then my dad started farming with him and with his two brothers. I never went to college. Learned everything from watching my dad since I was 2-3 years old, wanting to be with him all the time. Taught me to be a good steward of the land and take care of your family and take care of your community. We all need each other, and it just works when we're all working together.
The address, I kind of had a good idea we were going to end up there, and when I looked it up then, and it was the Graybrook Farm, I knew, you know, that it was going to probably be somebody that I knew.
Every year we fill our bins, we empty our bins over and over, same thing, but it's every year's a little different. The quality of the grain isn't as good, it spoils faster. If you don't haul it out until summer, it can go bad, and that's when things can turn ugly.
Grain Bin Safety Week started in 2014, and the thought process was the zero entry mentality of not having a farmer get into the bin, but if they did have to get in, what are the safe ways to make it happen? Nationwide started putting out feelers to the folks that they insured in the grain industry and started taking donations. Today, the Grain Bin Safety Week has delivered 111 rescue tubes, I believe in 23 states, and 4 of them have been used to successfully rescue somebody trapped out of a bin.
That morning I showed up, it was a beautiful day out. My dad and uncles were gonna clean a grain bin out, and if you have to go in that grain bin, it's dangerous. It's just part of the job, and my dad, he got in there and got the auger, basically sucked him down. When I found out my dad was in there, I looked down and, you know, it was 30, 40 feet down, and all I could see was the top of his face.
I was with my dad. I had my pager on open, and I heard the call come in for London. I immediately pretty much told him, let's get turned around and heading back.
Yeah, so this here was the grain bin that my dad was actually in when they called 911 to get somebody to come and help him.
Every time you breathe in and breathe out, grain's gonna get tighter, which means that next breath you're gonna take is not gonna be able to be as deep.
It's unbelievable how fast they showed up. You could tell they were trained, they knew what to do, they didn't panic, and it's all because they got the proper training.
Our team is very confident in using the tube. They used to be a recovery, not a rescue. The trend is changing in that direction, and that comes with the equipment and the training made available. For Nationwide to package that all together, it makes great sense.
Hey, Matt, how's it going?
Good, how are you, Joey?
Good, good.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
Yeah.
So that day that you came on the call, all of a sudden, it's like, I see you and your dad, and your dad just comes running, you come running, and yeah. That has relieved me some. I'm just thankful that there's companies out there to donate and train you guys, and you guys take the training to heart to help save my dad's life, and thank you. Thank you for coming out here.
Every time that I get a phone call and, you know, somebody identifies, hey, you know, you were here last year and you delivered a tube, you're never gonna guess what. We used it and it worked. The people in our office always know when that happens, because I'll hang up and give a woohoo.
Beautiful, beautiful.
I have one.
Yeah, let's hear it.
How did it feel to save his life?
Pretty good. He was about like family. And for that outcome, that day, there wasn't a better feeling.
Nationwide was here right now. I just like to tell him thank you. Thank you for the training. Thank you for the rescue tube that helped save my dad. There's only so many pancake breakfast fundraisers we can have, and it's really nice to see a big company step up to the plate.
In a rural setting, you know the people that you're responding to on a first-name basis. You know their kids, their family, their job. So when it's someone you know, it's better off. In the end of the day, that it turned out the way it did.